Hello, good morning, everybody. My name is Obinna, and I just want to share a quick one with us today. As God just laid something deep in my heart, and I said, okay, let me share it with my people. It's about your belief system. What do you believe? What do you believe? If only you can believe, all things are possible. The Bible makes us understand that if you can believe, all things are possible. You see, I've listened to a lot of motivational speakers. I've listened to a lot of people. And these people are not believers. They are not Christians. They don't read the Bible. But yet, when they speak about experiences, when they speak about the mind, when they speak about the belief system, it's just so amazing because it's almost as if they are speaking about the word of God. It's almost as if they are preaching about the word of God. So this is one thing I've come to understand, that even the unbelievers, they agree with. And that is our mind. Our mind is the epicenter of everything. You might be a very spiritual person. You might be a tongue-speaking Christian filled with the Holy Ghost. But if you have a defeated mindset, if you have a defeated mentality, it's going to be very difficult for you to do so much. You see, Jesus says something, that to them that believe, all things are possible. To them that believe, all things are possible. What do you believe about yourself? What do you believe about your business? What do you believe about your school? What do you believe about your finances? What do you even believe about your spiritual walk with God? What do you even believe about your eternity in heaven? All these things matter. You see, the Bible makes us understand this thing, that to them that believe, all things are possible. That if only you can believe, if only you can believe, if only you can believe. So what do you believe? Now, as I said earlier about the motivational speakers, I've listened to these people and it's just so amazing because these people are speaking based on their experiences. They're speaking based on the experiences of others, and they've come to understand this thing, that your mind moves in the, your life moves in the directions of your thoughts. What have you been thinking about yourself? What kind of thoughts have you allowed into your head or into your spirit? Is it the thoughts of your parents? Is it the thought of your family? Is it the thought of your school teachers, those around you? Is it the thought of what have you believed about yourself? Is it thoughts that say that you cannot be anything? Maybe some of us, we are brought up in an abusive home where we are told that you cannot be anything. You're a useless person. The way you're going, you'll just be useless. There's nothing you can do with your life. Are these the thoughts you believe? Or is it with your friends that have told you that you can never be anything? You're a loser. You're a failure. Are these the thoughts you have believed? If you believe these things and you walk in these things, you will remain like that. That's just the truth. So we need to understand that it's whatever you see for yourself, whatever you believe about yourself, is what you become eventually. That is why it's very, very important that you work on your belief system. Work on renewing your mind. The Bible says something in Romans 12 to say that, be ye transformed. It is through the renewal of your mind that you are transformed. As you renew your mind, you are transformed. See, be transformed by the renewal of your mind. So this is why it's very important. It's very, very important. It can never be emphasized. You need to change your belief system. You need to begin to see that it is possible. It is possible. And you know the funny thing? Motivational speakers can speak all day and speak to people, telling them you can be all you can be, you can whatever you set your heart to do, you can do this, you can do that, you can do this, and which is all true. But if you don't have the main element, it's very difficult to be that which they have said. What do I mean? It's just like a woman who is healthy. She has her eggs, she has her womb with her. She's a very, very healthy woman. And you go and meet her and she's telling you that, oh, she wants to be a mother. And you say, yes, you can be a mother. You have your eggs, you have the womb, you can be a mother. You can have, even have, if you want to have 10 children, you can have 10 children. Just know, because you have the womb in you, you have everything in you. And she believes you and runs with that. It's true. You have told her the truth, because that's who she is. She's a woman, a healthy woman. She has everything. But the truth is this, there's one thing she needs. Without it, she can stay up to 80 years without having a child. And she can come and tell you that, I thought you said I'm a healthy woman and I will have a child. How come I've not had a child? It's true, you didn't lie to her. She could. But she was missing one element. And that is, she needs the seed of a man. Of a man. She needs the sperm of a man inside her so that she can be able to conceive. Without that, no matter how healthy she is, she will never have a child. So telling people and telling them that they can do all things, they can be whatever they want to be, without the main thing, and that is God. And that is where you, as a believer, you are different. You can be all that you can be, but you have God in you. So studying the word of God, God has given us everything. The Bible makes us understand that He has given us all things pertaining to life and godliness. It is so true. It is so true. Jesus said something in Mark 11, 24. I love that scripture so much. He said that whatsoever you ask for God in prayer, believing that you have received, you will have it. It's true. I need you to understand that this is true. Whatever you believe, if you don't believe it, Look at the rich people. Look at the billionaires. Some of them are not even believers. But through experiences, they have come to understand that they have become that which they have believed. Now, you don't need to go through all those experiences. You don't need to go 50 years, 60 years before you come to that place. The word of God has made it available. You see, today people are just rediscovering things about life. And they are telling people, and people are excited about it. But it's funny because the word of God has had this thing inside. It's been in the Bible for years. The Bible has made us understand the power of our mind. The Bible says that as a man thinks in his heart, so he is. Finish. That's all. As a man thinks in his heart, so he is. Whatever you believe about yourself, it is who you are. Do you believe you are a loser? You are a loser. Do you believe you are a winner? You are a winner. Do you believe you are a success? You are a success. That's all. Now, when you believe that, you begin to act like it, you begin to walk like it, you begin to talk like it, and eventually you become it. You eventually become it. So it is very important that we work on our belief system. Let's refuse to allow negative thoughts come into our hearts. Anybody that is not contributing to your purpose, to your vision, anybody that just want to use negative words to hold you down, put them aside. They are not a part of your life. Only surround yourself with purpose-driven people, people who see things the way you see things, people who understand things the way you understand things, people who know that with God, all things are possible, people who are running towards their vision and purpose without fear, knowing that they can be all that God has called them to be. So that's what I want to share with us today. It's very important. Study the word of God. Let it soak into you. Look for scriptures. Believe those scriptures. There are some scriptures I don't joke with. There are scriptures I've come across. You see, the scripture will tell you that with God all things are possible, that he has given me the keys to the kingdom of heaven and earth. Whatsoever I bind on earth is bound in heaven. He has made me to understand that he has given me all things pertaining to life and godliness. He has also made me to understand that that with him I can do all things. I am not limited. I can never be limited. As far as my eyes can see, I can be. So what do you believe about yourself? What have you believed? Begin to work on your belief system. Begin to see only what God sees. Anytime a negative thought is coming into your head, say, I refuse it. I can be all that God has called me to be. That is as simple as that. So if motivational speakers are speaking and telling people these things, and they are telling you these things because it is true. It is true. I know it is true because the word of God said it. And since the word of God said it, then it is true. It is not completely true. So run with it. Believe it. You just change the way you think. Change the way you speak. Let the way you think transform your life. Believe only what God has said about you. You can be all that God has called you to be. Remember, you are backed by God. God is on your side. So this is just the only thing I want us to understand, and this is what I want us to share today. If only you can believe. If only you can dare to believe. That assignment, it is not too big. There is nothing too big for God. It's not too big. Run for it. Run for it. Look at things around you. You might look like, oh, I don't have the resources. I don't have what I need. Then you have to become resourceful. What do you have around you? Use those things you have around you to be. Nothing is to say. The Bible makes us to understand that you should not despise your humble beginnings. Do not look at the small things around. Don't say that this thing is too small. Maybe it's too big. Your vision looks so big and you feel like you don't have enough things. You don't have enough materials. Look. It's okay for you to have a big dream. It's okay for you to think big, but you have to start small. What do you have around you? The little things you have around you. How do those things you have around you, how can it help you to move towards your goal? Just do it, knowing that God is. Do not allow any negative thoughts. I get violent when negative thoughts come to me or someone tries to suggest something negative to me. Yesterday I was discussing something very important with someone, and because the person is such a negative-minded person, the person was trying to tell me how this is. Immediately I shot the person. I told him, stop, I don't think that way. Instantly, she was so surprised. I said, stop it, I don't think like that. And these are thoughts that, it's thoughts like this that can keep you in a place. Don't think this way. Instantly shut it off. Do not allow negative thoughts into your heart. Run with your vision. It's okay. Failure, it's okay, you might fail, but the Bible makes us understand that the righteous can fail so many times, but God will still lift them up. So don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Run. Believe that with God, all things are possible. So that's what I want to share with us today. If you have any comments, if you have any questions, please do not hesitate to leave it in the comment section below. It's awesome when I hear from people, when I hear your comments, when I hear your contributions. It's awesome because we are all growing together. We are all supporting each other together. So when you leave comments like this, even me, it inspires me. It also teaches me, helps me to learn also. So please leave your comments, leave whatever you want to say down in the comment section below. And if you have not also subscribed to this channel, please subscribe. I'll be releasing awesome comments, content like this as God lays it in my heart every week. So please Remember, you are backed by God. Let this be the only thing you have in your mind. You are backed by God. Therefore, you can do all things. All things are possible for you. Have an awesome week. And remember, God loves you. Take care of yourself.